Okay, now we're going to do an obtuse triangle, which also has a different characteristic from a right triangle and an acute triangle. It'd be good if you could see this from the top because it's difficult to see all of these angles. This is what this triangle really looks like. And once again, we're going to imagine where that perpendicular bisector would be. This is about the midpoint, and a perpendicular line going through the midpoint's about right there. Make my arcs. Make this line go really far because it's hard to tell where the circumcenter is going to be on an obtuse triangle. Okay, this is about the midpoint of this short side here. And that is sort of perpendicular. I'm sort of making a white line now instead of an actual true marker line. I hope that's pretty accurate. Yeah, that's more accurate than what my guess was. Oops. Better mark than that. Okay, now we can see where the three are going to cross because these two have crossed. Okay, and then the last one, midpoint is about right there, and perpendicular, that's about like that. Okay, now my compass doesn't reach, so I'm going to have to open up my compass some. This one again because I did a terrible job on that. So my circumcenter is outside of the circle on an obtuse triangle. You can see how each of these are right angles. Can see that better from up above.